This is what I call a successful failure. I left here 3 days ago for Fresno to pick up a trailer that a lady wanted me to restore for her, a 65 Roadrunner. And this is what I came back with: a successful failure. This is a great lesson. This is what I preach about all the time. It's in my videos. I teach it in my classes, my online classes. Never, ever purchase a trailer on eBay or anywhere else for that matter that you cannot go physically inspect. This lady paid $2,500 for this trailer on eBay. It was delivered from Utah to California at night, dropped off, and the next morning when she went out and took a look at what she had, her heart sunk. She knew she had made a mistake. $2,500, pretty much down the drain. After inspecting this trailer, I realized that it was not safe to tow in its present condition. It would have to be rebuilt there. There was nothing I could do to make it safe. And she had already moved to Idaho, and the trailer had to be gone off the property. It was Labor Day weekend. Nothing was open. Actually, the dump was open, but they won't accept an entire trailer. Scrapyard won't accept the entire trailer either. So it had to be dismantled. And there were some parts that were worth saving. She had spent a lot of money. All that in that black plastic there is all the new seats for the gaucho and the dinette. But that's all new vinyl. They've been completely rebuilt, brand new seats. That's the first thing she did for it. And then she ripped off the front end, realized that it was just so far gone that she didn't think that she could handle it. So she hired me to restore it for her. But even what you see here, parts of it were coming off all the way back yesterday. It was losing the belly pan piece by piece. And I had to keep stopping and checking to make sure that I wasn't leaving a trail. And looking in my rear view mirror to make sure nothing was flying off and hitting people. We'll watch the footage together, what footage I was able to take. It was 110 degrees. And I luckily had a little bit of cloud cover and got started early in the morning to take this trailer apart so I could, you know, end up with what you see here. Yeah, 3 days ago that was a 65 Roadrunner. Well, we just got here, and there it is, 64 Roadrunner, possibly a 65. I'm gonna let the dog out here for a bit. That was an 8-hour trip. Yeah, exactly 8 hours. And so I'm gonna get out and take a look at what I gotta do here. Looks like it might be worse than I thought. This is a fairly sad story. I'll give you the quick rundown, and then I got to get underneath this thing and see if it's worth, see if I can make it safely towable. I really, at this point, doubt that I can, but we're going to give it a shot. If I can't make it safe to tow all the way back to my place, which is an 8 to 10 hour drive over the Sierras, down the 99 or up the 99, which is a very bumpy freeway. If I can't make it safe to tow, then it's gonna get cut up and take to the dump. It's a 65 Roadrunner, and the lady bought it on eBay. This is what I tell my students in my class, and I preach it on my videos. Never, ever buy a trailer on eBay unless you can go there and inspect it in person. The pictures that they showed on eBay made this look like a cute little trailer with only a couple of little dings here and there. They made it look beautiful in the pictures. But they delivered it all the way from Utah. This is California, Fresno. They delivered it all the way from Utah, showed up at night, dropped the trailer off. She paid $2,500 for this. You know, and she had already paid it before they would deliver it. So they dropped it off and off they went. She got up the next morning and realized she had made a big mistake. I don't want this to happen to anybody else. Never, ever, ever buy a trailer on eBay unless you can go inspect it in person. This happens all the time, folks, more often than you think. So she tore into the front, and this is what she found. Nothing but rot everywhere. And from the pictures, it looked okay because they covered up a lot of things. Looks like it was done in oak. But the see, it's all rotten. The entire trailer is completely rotten. It's going to be a frame-up restore, and she can't do that. So now she's wanting me to do it. And I told her it's going to be $15,000, and because she paid $2,500 for it and she paid me $1,300 just to come here and get it, and I may not be able to take it home, she's gonna have $20,000 into this thing, and it's only gonna be worth maybe $9,000 or $10,000 when I'm done. But she loves the little trailer. So I'm gonna get underneath now and see if I can make it safe to tow all the way back to my place. But from the looks of it, from what I can see right here, I don't think I can. Well, right off the bat, there's a carriage bolt. It's just hanging there, it's not doing anything. So that's not good. The whole underside, you can see they put the underside back up with drywall screws, you can see here, just to hold it up out of the way for travel. So the people that delivered it knew it was a piece of junk. Of course the front end's gone, but there's another carriage bolt. The springs are old, and they don't look broken or anything, but I see a spring perch over there that's bent. That's not good. I'm gonna go over there and take a look at that now. You see that over there? Just above the axle, that spring perch looks bent. Okay, the spring perch here looks to be okay. So this one looks okay. The only way, oh my God. You know, the back end here is all soft. You know this is all, look at this, they put all these screws in here to try and hold the metal in, and you can tell it's all rotten in there. I would have refused delivery on this and made a complaint to eBay and gotten my money back. This is not what they said it was. It's not $2,500 worth of trailer, it's about $1 worth of trailer. Matter of, you couldn't give me this trailer for free. Well, you could. I'd junk it, take the parts out of it, the windows and the oven. There's what I'm talking about, right there. All I did was jiggle this like that a little bit, and that front dropped. You see? It dropped right to the ground. All it would have taken was a couple of miles of Highway 99, and that's what would happen to this trailer, and I'd be stuck with a big mess on the freeway. So that's why you have to do these things right. Look at that. Amazing. So it's not going to take much to dismantle the rest of it. It's about 10:30. I've been working on it since about 7. I got it completely gutted and falling, literally falling off the trailer now. So, just amazing. Just amazing. Well, there it is. What's left of the trailer. Gonna take this home. So it's all the cushions in those black bags. Brand spanking new vinyl on them and everything. Oh, what a shame. The flatbed, the stove, the ice box, and the water tank, sink, and hood. That's it. So I'm leaving Fresno. And this was a fun couple of days. It was hot. God, it was 109 yesterday. I did all this. Luckily the sun was behind the clouds and I got done just in time before the sun came out. So now for the 10-hour drive home. I'm used to restoring trailers, not demolishing them. Oh well. Yep. So here we go, through farm country for a long ways, all the way to Sacramento. And then from there up 50 towards Lake Tahoe, over the Sierras, down to Gardnerville and home to Yerington. Hope it goes all right. So far, everything has been fine. Now we just gotta get home safely. I gotta get a tire on this right side because I don't like it. So I'm gonna stop and get a tire.